Hoboken High School's Class of 2023 commencement ceremony. Outside. Yes, outside. I think I have like 20 extra gray hairs after the weather today. Could everyone please remain standing as I invite Miss Gina, Cruz, our president of the Class of 2023, to recite the Pledge of Allegiance. This time I'd like to ask Kiera Pena to the podium as she will be singing our national anthem. So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And rockets rang there, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet today, I welcome each of our families and the friends of our graduating seniors. I also would like to take a few moments to welcome our distinguished guests. Dr. Johnson, Superintendent of Schools, Ms. Rodriguez Gomez, Assistant Superintendent of Schools, Ms. Good, our Business Administrator, Mr. Calgary, our Director of Facilities, Dr. D'Elia, our Director of Special Services, and our Board of Ed members, Ms. Angley, Ms. Cademartori, Mr. Delatori, Mr. Grana, Ms. Khanna, Mr. Kluepfel, Ms. McGuirk, Ms. Noorwood, and Ms. Tagleri. We are extremely grateful to all of you for providing opportunities for our students. The programs being offered at Hoboken High School are the best in New Jersey, so thank you. We are also honored to welcome Mayor Bala, Hudson County Freeholder, Anthony Romano, City Council members, Emily Jabor, Michael Russo, Joe Quintero, Ruben Ramos, Jim Doyle, and Phil Cohen. Forgive me if I forgot everyone. You all are so welcome to be here. As you know, this is not a one-woman show. There are so many people that assist in getting all of you to this stage. They often say it takes a village. Mr. Terry, our 12th grade counselor, who came in mid-year, we threw him right into the fire. After only interning for a year, he ensured that everything was in place for all of you to realize what you have been working towards. He had an excellent mentor in Ms. Gleason, as she assisted along the way. They arranged everything from college planning, financial aid night, college fair, college campus visits, and instant decision days. That dedication and commitment led over to $15.5 million in institutional scholarships, and you also earned $65,000 in private scholarships. Well done. My administrative team that I would be lost without: Mr. Ponce, Mr. Williams, Mr. Baker, and Mr. Dickerson, and our newest additions, Mr. Benway, AKA Uncle Ben, and Dr. Carr, for all your work every day. Our faculty has worked with all of you for the past 4 years, ensuring that you have what it takes to move forward and to get to this point in time. I am constantly reminded how Hoboken High School faculty is second to none and have prepared you with the skills you need to continue your work. I am thankful to be working alongside such esteemed people. This year we bid farewell to a few of our faculty members. Ms. Lingello, 32 years, she is retiring to enjoy her grandchildren. And Mr. Apicella, 39 years, who is retiring to enjoy PA and gardening. We are going to miss you both, but we wish you the best in your retirement. Last and certainly not least, Mr. Munoz, who along with Ms. Munoz, Mildred, Angela, have really done such a great job at organizing for the senior class. He made this year special for all of you, giving so much time and energy to ensure you all had a memorable year. I am not quite sure when this man sleeps. I imagine that is what summer is for, and he should wake up around mid-July. Those we love do not go away. They walk beside us every day, unseen, unheard, but always near, still loved, still missed, and very dear. I would like to take a moment of silence for the truest Red Wing, Madeline Maddie Ramos. Thank you. So this is number 10, my 10th graduation, my 10th graduation speech. And like all my speeches before, besides boring you all to death, I always like to find a story that somehow captures what I want to say or share with you. It's called The Value of Money. At the beginning of a school year, a class teacher stands up in front of her students holding a $100 bill. She tells them, "Put your hands up if you want this $100 bill." All their hands go up, to which the teacher says, "I am going to give this money to someone here, but first let me do this." She takes the bill and crumples it up in her hands before asking, "Who still wants this $100? All the hands stay up. The teacher then takes the $100 bill and drops it on the floor and stomps and grinds it into the ground and picks it back up. She says, "How about now?" The hands stay up. "I hope you see the lesson here," she says. "It did not matter what I did to this money. You still wanted it because the value stayed the same. Even with its creases and dirtiness, it's still worth $100. It's the same with us. There will be times in our lives when we feel dropped, we feel bruised, and we feel muddled. Yet no matter what happens, you never lose your value. Life's hardships are inevitable, and we will all be put through the ringer at some point in our life. Nobody escapes it, and it's often through no fault of our own. In spite of these challenges, do not let these challenges alter your feelings of self-worth. You will always be enough. You have something unique and special to give and offer the world. I know that, having spent the past 4 years with all of you. While this is an exciting time, it is also a time where we can feel uncomfortable, and that is okay. It is when we are uncomfortable in life that we develop our strengths, without which we would not grow. There are times in life we will be faced with what seems impossible. And when those times arise, I want you to remember, absolutely nothing is impossible. That is often where we uncover our greatest potential. Sometimes there is no way around it, but we must go through it. John Dewey said, "Education is not preparation for life. Education is life itself. While graduation is a culminating event and what many would consider the end of a journey, I encourage you to look at this instead as a part of your journey. Relish in your accomplishments and embrace the continuation of this journey. Keep your thirst for knowledge at the forefront. Education is not a point in time, it is a lifelong journey and you must embrace it." I love the song, "The Time of Your Life" by Green Day. And I often hear it, and I'm not going to sing it, I promise you that, but the first verse always makes me think of this time. Like I said, it can be daunting and uncomfortable. Here we go. "Another turning point, a fork stuck in the road. Time grabs you by the wrist, directs you where to go. So make the best of this test, and don't ask why. It's not a question, but a lesson learned in time. It's something unpredictable, but in the end you'll see. I hope you have the time of your life." To all my class of 2023, you have brought joy to my life, and I thank you for that. Your sense of humor has made me laugh on more than one occasion. Continue to make others laugh, but more importantly, be able to laugh at yourself. It will teach you humility. Be kind. Be peaceful. Forgive and be happy. This is the last time I say it, but you know I mean it from my heart. Make it count. Much love and happiness to all of you. Namaste." At this time, I'd like to have a warm welcome for Mayor Bala.
Good evening, thank you. I'm the Indian mayor. I thought I was supposed to say namaste. No? Okay. But we are blessed with beautiful weather. Thank you, Superintendent Dr. Johnson, for this great weather, and Ms. Pick. You know, this really takes a village, or in this case, a city. This graduation, and I've had the honor of speaking at a few graduations, the middle school one most recently earlier this afternoon, but guys, this is it. This is it. You've reached the culmination of your educational careers, and each and every one of you should be so proud, and you should raise your chin up high, and the parents, the uncles, the aunts, the grandparents, the friends, the relatives, the family, the community. This is all about community. This is a coming together of our entire community here in Hoboken to say to the graduates from the class of 2023, we support you, we are proud of you, we love you, and we wish you the best in the next step of your journey, no matter what it may be. Sometimes they say, don't let school get in the way of your education. And what I mean by that is kind of what Ms. Pick was saying, that education is a journey. It's not just in the four corners of your classroom. Education is right now. Education is tonight. Have fun tonight. Relax and enjoy yourselves. Party, celebrate, do whatever you gotta do. Hug your parents, your loved ones. But as Ms. Pick said, education is a lifelong journey. And on behalf of the city of Hoboken, we're so proud and honored and happy for all of you today. So please enjoy yourselves, and congratulations to everyone. Thank you.
At this time, I'd like to ask Kiara Pena to join us back up at the podium. She will be performing Somewhere Only We Know by Keen. Branches of it looking at me. Well, well done. That is not easy. So, at this time, I'd like to introduce the salutatorian of the class of 2023, Francis Franny Michaels. Franny will be attending Rutgers Honors College in the fall.
As Ms. Pick just said, but the truth is, my name isn't important today. I've been chosen as a representative of our class, but I don't feel comfortable speaking for all of you. I didn't walk down those red locker-filled halls of Hoboken High School in the same shoes that you did. So, I'm not going to try to speak for you. I'm not going to go on a tirade about what our class is feeling and how nervous we are for this next chapter of our lives. No. Instead, I want to speak to you. And what I want to say is this. I have absolutely no idea what to say to you guys. I have always wanted to speak at graduation. I remember the first day of school in English 1 honors in Mr. Troutman's class, a Mr. Glenn Gallopon, when asked what his vision was for himself in 4 years. He stood up in front of the entire class and told everyone he wanted to be the valedictorian. And internally, I said, over my dead body. Because I wanted to speak at graduation. What on earth was I thinking? Now, I'm not valedictorian, but I still spent so much time working to get to this point, waiting to speak to you guys. And I've been asking myself over the past few weeks, what do I want to say? Do I want to be inspirational, sappy, excited for our futures? I've written several drafts of this speech and nothing has really felt right. Nothing felt authentic because I wasn't writing what I was truly feeling. But what's real is that I didn't know what to say. I don't know. And you know what? That's how I feel about what's to come. I don't know. I don't know whether I'm going to succeed in college. I don't know whether I'm going to be able to keep up with the coursework. I don't know whether I'm going to be able to keep my room clean without my mom bugging me. I don't know if I'm going to be able to handle sharing a room with someone I've never met before. I don't know if I'm going to be able to survive with communal bathrooms. But hey, at least these ones won't be locked every time you try to use them. I don't know. I used to hate that feeling, loathed it, despised it. Not knowing something, that was my worst enemy. Anyone who has ever had a class with me knows that I was the last person not to know something, and if I didn't know something, that would be followed by immediate panic. But I'm not panicking. For once, I'm not scared of what I don't know. It's exciting, exhilarating even. I don't know what's gonna happen next, but I'm gonna try to make the best of it. I don't know, I'm gonna try thriving college. I'm gonna try to keep up with the coursework. I'm gonna try to keep my room clean, for the most part. I'm gonna try to get along with my roommate, even though living with someone can be really difficult. And I'm gonna try to get comfortable with sharing a bathroom with 500 strangers. Hopefully, some of those strangers will turn into my friends. I don't know, but I'm gonna try. Try to be the best version of myself, whoever that turns out to be. Try to keep in touch with my friends, because there are some that I'm not ready to say goodbye to yet. Try to remember what the mentors in my life taught me. Mr. Huggins and Mr. D, wherever you are today, I won't forget, I promise. For once in my life, I feel confident enough to value effort rather than success. So when someone asks me, how do I think the class of 2023 is going to turn out? Will they succeed? Well, of course, my answer is, I don't know, but they are sure as hell gonna try. Congratulations, everyone, to family members and friends, but especially to my fellow classmates, and to the one who couldn't be with us today. It's been an honor to spend the last 4 years with you. I wish you guys all the luck in the world. Thank you.
Thank you, Franny. Next, I'd like to invite up Kai Holstrom, class of 2023 valedictorian. He will be attending the University of California, San Diego in the fall.
Hello, everyone. Before I start, I'd like to thank everyone who came here today to celebrate this occasion. Firstly, I'd like to thank all the families that have come here to support your graduates. Needless to say, none of us would be here without you. Secondly, thanks to all the teachers that have challenged us all through the years, the guidance counselors for guiding each of us, all 100 plus of us, through our personal situations and individual ambitions. I would also like to thank Mr. Williams, Mr. Ponce, Ms. Pick, and the rest of the staff for helping organize this event. Personally, I'd like to give out a shout out to Mr. LeBay for his mentorship through the Student Space Flight Experiments Program. And lastly, I'd like to thank Mr. Munoz for his friendliness and his unimaginable amount of sass. High school graduation is perhaps the biggest milestone any of us has experienced yet. I'm sure we have all dreamed of this day to come, and we are now given the chance to take the next step to truly be ourselves and for the many adventures, challenges, and opportunities that life has to offer. But let's remember what has led up to this very moment. Initially, our introduction to high school seemed innocuous enough. As freshmen, we're all feeling our way around the first year of high school. Then, just as we settled in around the halfway mark of freshman year, we were hit with the most significant pandemic in 100 years. We all thought it would just last 2 weeks, but the hiatus just kept expanding, from 2 weeks, to 4 weeks, to 4 months, to a whole year. I remember how exciting it felt to have what was expected to be a 2 week break just fall into our laps. But soon enough, excitement morphed into boredom, and then uncertainty. We all had to make do and adapt quickly to make the best of the ever-changing situation. Remember all the scheduled classes canceled, labs missed, and carefully planned curriculums aborted. Remember all the adaptations we had to make, all in the midst of a health crisis that was dire for some, devastating for others. Somehow, we came through, thanks to the diligence and hard work of all the Hoboken school administration, teachers, and us. It can sound almost cliche to bring up COVID, but think about that. We actually have the luxury of thinking of that period as a been there, done that moment. What we should not miss, and we'll have time to reflect on, is how that moment in time actually affected our outlook in life, our approach to dealing with problems, and how it influenced our view on basic human interaction and challenged our sense of permanence. Even once we returned to school during our sophomore year, the landscape, literally, had changed with a few oddities here and there. Face masks had become the new norm. We got used to parking ourselves in the midst of massive plastic shields on our desks and tables. But we took that all in stride, and eventually, the wake of the pandemic left slowly closed. Life essentially returned back to more familiar rhythms, and we had a relatively relaxed junior year. Now, here we are in senior year, sitting in these seats with our caps and gowns, ready to graduate. But even this year, we still found a lot of hurt. Earlier in the year, we lost Coach Tagleri. I still remember him from middle school, his no-nonsense attitude, and we'll all miss his presence. Then, after Ms. Tagleri, we lost one of our seniors, Madison Ramos. Even though Madison and I were not in the same circles, he and I had gone to Collaboro Elementary School together, as well as Hoboken Middle School. I can see what an energetic, outgoing, sweet, kind, and loving person she was. I wish she could be with us. Imagine her sitting among us right now in her old cape and gown. I know mentioning all this may still touch in a fresh wound, but I hope we all remember Madison for the positive energy she brought to us all. We as a whole have been through so much. High school is full of challenges and changes, and you can feel like life is throwing big bricks at you all this time, academic, personal, and physical challenges. You all know what I mean. They face us every day. Yet, even though some of those bricks hit hard and knock you down for a bit, look at where we are. We've always gotten back up. Really, that's the best you can do. That's what you have to do. No matter what you're hit with, no matter how hard or how jarring it may be, you have to get back up. For me, even having to give a speech was like another brick joining me. Yet here I am still standing, hoping I don't faint. We have been lucky to have lived in Hoboken. Think of what this place represents. Although we take it for granted, it is a rich learning ground. When people talk about diversity, we have that in spades. We grew up with it. When you think about environmental challenges coming our way, we've been through all that, flooding, for example. And we continually find ways to find potential solutions to significant issues. In this tiny mile square, urban planning is critical. We see the constant changes and renewal that this town undergoes. This place has been a great learning ground. We are used to change and adaptation just by virtue of having grown up here. I mention this rich learning ground because it is our springboard. This generation has some pretty daunting problems to tackle. This generation is going to have to find better ways of inhabiting this earth. We're going to have to ask ourselves whether the way we live is the best way or old and erroneous. We're going to have to learn better ways of forming kind communities at scales local, statewide, national, and even global. Are you up for that challenge? Of course we are. Understand that we are all traveling down different paths. Some of us want to explore sports, some want to explore science, some of us love the arts, and some have absolutely no clue. It doesn't matter what your passion is, because we're all going to find a path forward. Some far, some just enough. Just remember, no matter how far you get in life, whether it be financially, physically, or any other leads in life, don't forget where you came from. Remember the friends you've made, the mentors that have taught you, the experiences you've had, and the people you've lost. Remember it all. Because even though it may hurt to remember sad or darker memories, you'll just as easily remember the good memories as well. And realize in the end, no matter how bad it gets or how ruthless life can be, you'll always be ready to get back up. Thank you, and congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Kai. So, we're getting to the meat of the event. But before we move on to the main event, I have the pleasure of introducing the Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Christine Johnson, who will certify the diplomas for the class of 2023.
On behalf of the Board of Education, the administration and staff, congratulations to the class of 2023. There's no doubt that you all deserve the very best opportunities that you will be presented with. We are confident that you have skills, courage, experience, and the resilience needed to turn those opportunities into both lifelong lessons and successful ventures. Think back on all of the chances you had in high school to meet new people, work different part-time jobs, join new clubs, activities, or sports, and take new classes. You've already learned about brass rings. You will be presented with so many of them in the years to come, and there are numerous people around you to provide you with comfort, support, and encouragement as you go after them. Don't be afraid to reach out and grab hold of each that comes before you. Regardless of your next step, whether it be college, the workforce, or travel, live, love, and prosper. And now for the highlight of the evening. At this time, I am honored as Superintendent of Schools for the Hoboken Public School District to certify to President Sharyn Angley and Vice President Malani Cademartori and the members of the Hoboken Board of Education that all students assembled here tonight for this very special and momentous graduation ceremony have in fact completed all of the requirements in accordance with the New Jersey Administrative Code and the Hoboken Public School District's graduation policies. By doing so, these fine young men and women are entitled to receive their diplomas and all rights and privileges therein. Principal Piccapietra, you are now permitted to issue diplomas to the class of 2023.
Mr. Terry, will you do the honors?
Yeah, So you guys are ready? Jalicia Alvarez. Amani Aviles. Angel Barrigan. Jalen Barrett. Luca Bakowry. Hannah Berman. Layla Bess. Aiden Betancourt. Jose Blanco. Brianna Brown. Autumn King. Casey. Bria Coleman. Justin Contreras. Gina Cruz. Yasmin Cruz. Michael D'Antonio. Logan Davis. Maxim DeBellin. Jaden Desrevere. Angelina Diaz. Giacomo. Feline Dirks. Xavier Dorda. Eric Espanol. Diego Ferrer. Neftali Figueroa. Joshua Flores. Dizanay Fuentes. Dasani, I'm so sorry. Glenn Galapon. Valeria Garcia Quintero. Joel Giovanetti. Aiden Golubchik. You got it twice, buddy. Aiden Kowalski. Avian Gomez. Harley Gonzalez. Lily Gonzalez. Pedro Gonzalez. Suhaley Gonzalez. Arnaldo Gonzalez Pacheco. Fernando Guevara. Brianna Hayes. Tiana Hayes. Anthony Henderson. Yeah. Jennifer Hoffer. Kai Holstrom. Juliet Heisen. Mohab Ibrahim. Jolie Giacobelli. Siani Jeffries. Daquan Jones. Aiden Kale. Harrison Corman. Timothy Magazinic. Sean Maida. Darwin Martinez. Maria Mastro Giovanni. Hudson Matula. Sarah McKay. Yeah. Anahi Mahia. Lindsay Mahia. Thank you.
Rodriguez.
Joshua Rosado. Caleb Suarez.
Okay, just one, I'm sure everyone noticed, but all the students are wearing an orange cord, and that orange cord is in memory and our love for Madison Munoz. At this time, I ask my class of 2023 to please stand up. Something, right? No. Let's go. Get your little books out. You promised.
gentlemen, this is a Hoboken High School tradition. So for all of our alumni out there, please sing along with us.
You must go out through the main entrance. All right?